It was so hard to get milk from kitchen. Now Ravi is further explaining about the problem. It is very difficult to get milk from kitchen. Why? You see. Okay, the next problem Ravi is facing is that he is finding very difficult to get milk from kitchen. Because sometimes he is caught by his grandmother while taking the milk. Pati saw him with a glass of milk in hand and looked suspiciously. So Ravi wants to feed the cat, but when he goes to kitchen to get milk, and as he takes milk from refrigerator, his grandmother, that is Pati, sees him and she looks to him with suspicious, like what he will do with this milk. So he had to drink most of the milk to throw her off the scent. So he drank most of the milk just to show that actually he wants to drink the milk and he is not taking it anywhere. But actually the milk was for kitten. But unfortunately he had to drink to show his Pati that he wants to drink milk. Now Pati asked the tumbler back, but you see Pati is much clever, so she says to Ravi, drink all the milk, no problem, and give the tumbler to me. Now Ravi thinks what to do, just a very little milk left in the tumbler. And then he says, I myself will clean the tumbler, don't worry. And then he rushes outside the house. Then he pours the milk into the half coconut shell for the kitten. So like this he is explaining Mridu and Meena about the struggles that he faces in order to look after the kitten. So now Ravi is giving some kind of suggestion to solve the problem. He says, now we have to think of some other way to feed Mahendran. He says, you see, now he is finding very difficult to feed the cat. Therefore, he is telling, we have to find some other way to look after or to feed Mahendran. Mahendran, this little kitty's name is Mahendran. Now, Mridu, first time hearing the word Mahendran, and which looks like a real name. So she is surprised. At the same time, she is impressed about the name, because it looks or it sounded very real. Now Ravi tells the full name of the kitten or the cat. He says the full name of Mahendran is Mahendra Verma Pallava Punai. He also says you can call this kitten MP Punai in short if you find difficult to take full name. So he loves his kitten so much. That's why he is just praising about the kitten. So Ravi is very happy about this cat. It is real in everyone's life. The thing we like so much, we praise or we talk about, right? So it is happening same with this man Ravi. He loves kitten, he likes kitten, so that's why he is praising so much about it. Further, you will see how he compares with Pallava king, how he relates with the ancient cat. We will see all these later. He says this cat is of very good breed. Now he compares the fur of cat with lion's mane. What is mane? Mane is the hair that lion has on his neck. So Ravi is just comparing his cat with the lion. You see, he is very happy with his cat. And Ravi also questions Mridu about the emblem of ancient Pallava kings. So now, what does Ravi do is that he asks Mridu whether she knows about the emblem of ancient Pallava kings. Okay. And then Mridu giggled. Giggle means laugh. Mridu, as a reaction, just laughs as if Ravi is joking. But Ravi is very serious. He is making stories in his mind. So Mridu just giggles. Now Ravi asked Mridu, haven't you been in Mahabalipuram? Have you? Ravi asked Mridu, have you ever been to Mahabalipuram? And then he tells the whole story about the experience when he had gone to Mahabalipuram for a trip from his school. This is very funny. He tells that when he last went there, he saw a statue of his Tatas, etc., etc. This is the exact text of Ravi, which says Tatas, etc., etc. Now, he meant to say that it was very ancient. Do you get it? His cat is very ancient. Or the statue is very ancient. Or basically, the fact is that Ravi wants to tell that Mahendran is a descendant of that very ancient cat. Again, you see, he is praising his cat again and again. Finally, Ravi concluded that This cat is a descendant of Mahabalipuram Rishi cat. So now what happens further? Meena and Mridu exchange their looks. Okay, Meena and Mridu are standing and listening to Ravi, what he is telling. Okay, it is what he is narrating. You know, when we listen to someone and we find that what the person is speaking has no relevance, then we show a different expression, right? And here, similarly, Mridu and Meena find no relevance to what Ravi is speaking. So, to disagree with him, they exchange their looks, saying like, what he is talking about? Is there any relevance to the story, this cat? Now, therefore, they ask with each other, what does that had to do with anything? Mridu demanded. Is there anything to do with the whole story, or simply he is praising his cat? So Ravi, in response to Mridu, says, I'm telling, this cat is descended from the Egyptian cat god. No, goddesses. So he is telling, I'm telling, this cat is descended from the Egyptian cat god. No, goddess. Bastard. Yeah, that's it. And this is where he ends praising about his cat. Now, let's see what happens in the next scene. There is a sound like a varied sound and screeching sound. So, Mahendran looks up alarmed. Okay, alarmed means alert or alerted. So Mahendran or Ketan is alert, hearing the noise. He was sharpening his claws on the edge of coconut shell. In the beginning, we read that Ketan was served milk with in half coconut shell, right? So with that coconut shell, the kitten was sharpening his claws. Screech sound comes. A varied sound comes from window. Mridu was startled. Startled means surprised and amazed. And kitten was also frightened. But the screeching sound did not stop. And Mridu asked surprisingly, what is the noise? All are just talking about the kitten, and suddenly a sound comes, some screeching sound comes. So Mridu asks about that sound. What is that noise? After that, what happens? Now, MP Punai also was frightened. Before Ravi tells Mridu about Lalli, who is playing violin, what happens is that after listening the screeching sound, MP Punai was so much frightened, so the cat bounced on a tray of red chilies and trying to hide beneath it. He tipped a few chilies over himself. You see, kitten is a very small creature, right? And if this kind of sudden noise comes, it will be horrified, frightened, right? So it runs and jumps on a tray which is full of red chilies. The tray falls down and the kitten is trying to hide beneath the tray. And so he is just taking a few chilies over himself to cover with it. Meow, he howled miserably. That means the kitten cried aloud. Now Ravi tells that Lali is learning to play violin. This is their the third cousin coming to the picture in the story, who is trying to learn how to play violin. So he compares master's singing like a train whizzing on and on, while Lali's train is derailing. Now here what happens in the story is that Ravi says that master singing is so good, which seems like a train running with the sound of whizzing, whereas Lali is unable to learn. So her singing, Ravi says, never comes to the track like a train. So how can it move smoothly? It simply means she is so far has learnt nothing from the music master. And thus, her singing is so horrible. So, that is the end of the first part of the lesson. And for the second part, we'll have another class. I hope you have enjoyed the story and learned the lesson. So, thank you for watching this video. Be focused in your studies and keep learning.